What is going on, everybody, and welcome back to another episode. It's your boy Drain here, and today we are back in American Truck Simulator. We are in the city of Bellingham, Washington. So we are really, really north at the minute. And today it's a special trip because we're going to Vernon, British Columbia. So we go in Canada. We're going to cross the border probably within the first 10 minutes of this video, because we really, really close to the border, and then we have about 300 miles into the Canada wilderness side, and I can't wait to explore that with you. Obviously, you know, I'm using the ATS map expansion for American Truck, and then we got a promodes from the promodes official website, which I can put it down below if you want, so you can get it from there. It's about $2 I think I've paid for the promodes, and yeah, we go in Canada today. We drive in our Kenny W900 Highway Killer, and I'm really excited to start this journey. We not hauling heavy today. We have some packaging to obviously drop in Vernon, and we should start. We should do the usual cold start and then hit the road. There we go. I love this sound. It's really early in the morning. We start loading the trailer around 6 o'clock. Took them about 2 hours to get me loaded, and now it's about 8. So yeah, we should be in Vernon by afternoon. If not, we'll
turn right.
We'll see. But as it stands, it's not a long trip. It's all about the road condition, which I'm not sure about, because never been Canada before. Hopefully will be uneventful, and you know, we'll enjoy the trip. Got my supplies in here, I got everything I need. So we're ready. Should have bought some water, to be honest, but I think I have something left in the fridge. If not, we'll stop on the road and we'll get some water. Another traffic light, of course. Washington, the state of traffic lights. Are we gonna go on interstate in a second? So we should be alright. That shouldn't stop us.
Keep right. And then turn right.
No problem, Morgan.
Turn right.
I'm really excited, guys, because it was my birthday last week, and I turned 30. I got a lot of cool stuff from you know, close friends and family, and people that I love and care about.
Exit right.
And my gaming room, it's coming together now because of the things that I got.
Continue straight.
I was thinking for the future, just to build
continue straight.
Oh, roadworks, come on. I was thinking to build a proper dash, but I'm not too sure.
Keep right.
Oh, that's not affecting us, because we're going right anyway in it, because, yeah, we can't go straight with the trucks, because that means going through city, and you can't do that, because of the restrictions. This is the Canada border. Nice, cool.
Continue straight.
Basically, we are in between, I guess. It can't be. No, it can't be like that. This is it. We're in Canada now. That was easy. We got another traffic light. Here we go, it's green. Come on, boys. Oh boy, I'm really, really excited that we got to get to Canada. I can't wait to see what today's gonna bring. Excited that I have my Kia Whooper back on the road. It's been in service for a while. We had a few engine problems.
Continue straight.
No problem, Morgan. Highway or something, the way it looks. We do, but it's different from the USA, isn't it? But they have kilometers per hour in Canada. I thought they use miles, as in, you know, USA. This is weird. And we're not in the French side of Canada, we are in the American parts. So. Weird. probably 60 then. Move outside for a second. Look at these massive mountains in here. My beautiful Kenny. Hope, which means the mountain on the right side is the Coquihalla mountain. If you watch the Highway to Through Hell on Netflix, you know what I'm talking about. It's really dangerous in here on winter. It looks like it's going to rain in a minute. Really cloudy in here. Well, I think we're really high altitude wise, so probably that's why. And we're driving an old school truck, so I can't see any temperatures, but I'm pretty sure it's a bit cold outside. Crazy guys, totally worth every buck for the pro modes. It's just insane. Second, trying to drive from outside, you know, it's not my one of my strengths, so I'll try my best. Hopefully we're not gonna crash into anything. And that was very close. Hard to stay in lane when you're driving from outside. I don't know why. Probably just because we used to drive from inside all the time, maybe. Because I'm not the only one complaining about this. I've seen a few YouTubers saying the same thing. It's pretty hard to drive from outside, especially these long lanes. This tunnel from Highway 3. I know this area. But look at the details, guys. This is amazing. Guys, I was checking my phone. Don't do that while driving, obviously.
TV series a lot years ago.
go. So that was just like a nice memory coming back. Basically, if your brake fails, just go straight and that will stop you. Which is kind of cool if you ask me. I know they exist in real life as well. I've seen a few in Europe as well, so yeah, it's a good thing, especially here, going down. Probably that's why you have that checkpoint in there where you can check your brakes. That's the worst moment to lose your brakes, when you're going down and you're heavy. Or an Impala. Not too sure. Might be an Impala though. 96, I think. That's nice. I was getting a bit busy, or busier. I was expecting this, to be honest, because you know, it's a rush hour, sorry, and you'll see a lot of people moving around and going from here to, you know, A to B, so I'm okay, we still have time, we're not late or anything. So we don't need to rush, we good. Trailer in front of us, they do brakes, discs and pads and everything, probably know them. Good company.
Continue straight.
To be honest, I think every of my truck has Goliath's brakes. Probably except two or three, which are a bit older, but they're gonna get changed as well, so yeah, it's a good company, guys, and I totally recommend to use their comment section, guys, because as I said, first time in Canada, and I'm pretty excited of the scene and what I've seen today in here. But I'm not good at lakes and, you know.
Keep right and then turn right.
For some reason, I don't know if it's the
turn right
mod order, but for some reason in Canada, I'm losing the FPS. It happened once, to be honest, or twice this video, but still it bothers me. And now I'm running on 48 FPS, so I wonder why. I don't have this problem in the States. This is weird. This is weird.
Turn left.
Problem, Mr. Morgan. There's a stop sign in there first.
In 400 meters, turn right. Turn right.
Confusing this road, but I think we got it and we should be with our client in a second. Yes. Here we go, and that's where we need to park. Guys, we made it, so I'll go and speak with the site manager, I guess. let them know we're here. You know, I'm not going to keep you here for the boring part. I hope you enjoyed today's episode and trip to Canada. Our first one was pretty nice, with a great scenery. So if you enjoyed this, please make sure you hit that subscribe button, guys. You know, it's much appreciated, and for you, it's totally free. Stay safe out there, and I'll see you next time. Thank you.